You're both writers, so I'm just going to go and ask this. Could you describe this film in 5 words?
Comedy about...
Uplifting comedy about cancer.
Yes, that's good. Hey, that's why we work together.
Yeah.
that's proof collaboration is better than a singular vision.
Now, Seth, you dropped the C-bomb in this movie in the most spectacular way.
Are you talking about cunt or cancer?
And we have our quote. Was that in the script, or did you just...
It was in the script.
I think it was in the script, yeah.
Yeah. But it was so appalling, I felt a need to improvise the line in the next scene that the date didn't work due to an overuse of profanity on my part.
It's funny. It's like, I will say, every once in a while, that word will slip out of my mouth, and my sister will be like, you cannot say that word. You cannot say that word. And it's like... And I'm not surprised that it was in the script. Yeah.
Yeah.
How does it feel to hear this film called a weepy for guys?
It's fun.
It's a dick flick.
I don't know how to react when people tell me that the movie made them cry. It's my instinct to apologize. Mm. I don't know if that... I think it means they liked the movie, so I shouldn't be apologizing. I should be thanking them. But it's my instinct to say I'm sorry.
We have seen grown men... You know,
it's the exact opposite reaction I'm generally hoping to get from one of my movies.
Oh, from life in general.
Yeah.
Now, Seth, you have one of the most amazing laughs, I think, in cinema. I think that's fair enough to say.
I'll take that.
Who are your favorite laughers? What are your favorite comedy or...
Eddie Murphy has to be one of the greatest comedy laughers ever. And he would just do it in everything. Like, it's the same. Like, it was great. And I wonder if I'm sure he gets the thing I get all the time, which is when he actually laughs in real life. You're like, you actually laugh like that. As though it's some, like, big fucking preconceived strategy on my, like, to create this persona that has an idiotic laugh.
Yeah. Like Urkel.
Yeah, that's a really weird crutch to
have. Yeah, it is a weird thing.
Now... This movie finishes on one of my favorite songs in the world ever, which is Pearl Jam's Yellow Ledbetter. Yeah. Was that your choice, or did that just happen?
Well, what happened was we
it's hard to think of a song to end
the movie on. Yeah, and then Jonathan Levine and I went through and probably picked 100 songs, and then we narrowed it down to 15, and then sat down Seth and Evan and a few other of the producers, and it just was... That was by far the best song to end the movie on. Unfortunately, it was the most expensive and the hardest to clear.
Yeah.
Damn you, Eddie Vedder.
Yeah. I know. He did it, though.
He did it. We had
What's funny is, like, it's hard to... Because, like, we had a lot of songs with lyrics that you would just read into so much.
Yeah.
And we were like... But it's hard to find a good song without lyrics. So the solution was then to find a song with lyrics that you can't understand.
We almost ended it with the MGMT song, Congratulations. But it was too...
The lyrics were too cryptic.
It was, like, weird, yeah.
Yeah, like, what are we congratulating? Yeah, it was very weird. That works well, though. And they're from Seattle, which is a nice...
It made sense. All around, it was perfect.
And finally, how hard was it on set to avoid the temptation to rub Joseph's head all the time?
I think I did rub it quite a bit. Yeah, I would try to work it into the scenes. It was hard, though. What's funny is, like... Because he wore a wig in every scene that he has hair, because we shaved his head the first day of filming the movie, and I would actually forget he was bald sometimes. Like, we'd shoot a few days in a row sometimes when he would have the wig on, and then, like, after work we'd hang out and he would show up and be bald, and I'd be like, oh, what the fuck? It was very startling.
I had no idea it was a wig. That's
pretty much. Yeah, it's a good wig.
Glad.
That's the Cobra Commander's wig, actually, I think. Thanks for the wig from G.I. Joe.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot.